In this illustration, we'll discuss a situation when a gamma decay followed by beta. Here, we are given that cobalt 57 decays to iron 57 by beta plus emission, and resulting iron is in its excited state and comes to ground state by emitting gamma rays. We are given that the half life of beta plus decay is 270 days and that of gamma emission is 10 to power minus 8 second, which is very low. And a sample of cobalt 57 gives this is the rate of gamma photons per second, and we are required to find the time after which the rate of gamma photon emission drops to this value. Here first we need to understand how the reaction is taking place. If we write down the nuclear reaction for this radioactive emission, and here we can see cobalt 57 first decays to iron 57, which is in its excited state. And this is the beta plus emission, and the half life here is given as 270 days. Now, in a very short time, this excited iron nucleus drops to the normal state of iron 57, plus it emits a gamma ray, or this is the gamma decay. And the half life here is, we can write as T2, which is 10 to power minus 8 seconds. That means there's a very slow decay process and there's a very fast decay process. That means if one cobalt decays to iron, then as soon as this iron is produced, immediately it will emit gamma decay because the half life time is very small. That means the rate at which these gamma photons are emitted will be controlled by this half-life time, because as soon as an iron is produced, gamma is almost instantaneously produced. So there is almost no or very small time lag in this reaction. That means in 1 second, if 10 cobalt decays to iron, that means in 1 second, again 10 gamma will be produced, because instantaneously iron decays to the normal state along with the gamma emission. So here we can say, here, overall half-life of gamma emission can be taken as 270 days, and we can ignore this time period because the second part of the reaction is almost instantaneous. We can also write as just after 1 beta plus decay, it is suddenly or almost instantaneously, we can say, followed by gamma emission. So here we can use decay law. So we can write by radioactive decay law, we can write activity of beta is same as activity of gamma, which is equals to initial activity multiplied by 2 to power minus T by T. So here we can write after time T, if activity is 1.25 into 10 to power 9 and initial activity was 5 into 10 to power 9 multiplied by 2 to power minus T upon 270 days. Then here we can see this 10 to power 9 gets cancelled out, and this 2 to power minus 2 is equals to 2 to power minus T by 270. On taking anti-log on both sides, this gives the time is equals to 2 into 270, this is equals to 540 days. That is the result of this problem.